Who did you use for your letter of reference? And any tips?
So it is three letters of reference, or at least it was when we applied. So I used my current employer, which I think might be a requirement, or at least it was that you used your current employer. And I used a coworker that I had worked with on a large project over the course of many, many months. So we had worked closely together. And then I actually seeked out somebody that used to be my supervisor when I was a medical first responder to provide the last one. So my strategy with that, and this is just my strategy, but I wanted somebody who had seen me in a medical role and seen me interact with patients and also had seen me train for a medical role. And then I wanted the person that I had worked with on the large project because I knew that she could speak honestly to how I work as a member of a team, especially because like working on a large project, we had had disagreements on what to do and we had worked through them. So I felt that she really reflected how I would be as a PA in a real world environment. So that's how I chose. And then my boss was the same thing. Like that was a requirement. And I knew that she had seen me work on several projects. So that's how I chose her as well. So I would just say, yeah, pick someone that can honestly speak to your work ethic and someone that you don't necessarily know. They're just going to list off a bunch of, you know, sort of qualities that they think they want to hear, like someone that can actually speak to who you are as a person.
This actually brings up, that was another difference. I noticed on the website, it's only two recommendation letters. But when I applied, yeah, it was also three. So I approached this by, I did my academic advisor, but also someone I did research with for 3 years during my first undergrad. She was also my professor for a number of classes. So I'd gotten to know her really well. She had gotten to know me really well in terms of my work ethic, just my personality. So I really appreciated that she could give that perspective. Then I also used my counseling supervisor. So the person that was the supervisor of on my shifts when I was doing counseling, she had seen me do a lot of counseling sessions. And so she could really speak to my ability to communicate. And she also worked in the medical field herself. So she also had that kind of background. And so she could help, you know, speak to that as well. And then I also used my supervisor for a nonprofit that I had worked for or volunteered for the past 3 years. So I had known him really well as well. So it really stresses the importance of building good and strong relationships with advisors, supervisors, throughout your undergrad, because that really does pay off when it comes to asking for letters of recommendation.
So what I'm hearing is that you didn't have three references from the same category of experience. So there was one for academic, potentially, one that verified an extracurricular or a job, and one that had a verified patient care experience or where you had worked with patients or clients one-on-one that could speak about that. And they all knew you fairly well. And it wasn't just a verification of your activities. So that's actually a very, very good tip.